name is Kelly Citrone, and I am a high school English teacher, mostly teaching the 12th grade, and I've been here for 23 years. I do believe there have been so many women throughout history that have paved the way for women like me. So women like, you know, Rosa Parks and our current VP Kamala Harris and Elizabeth Cady Stanton, I think are all very influential.
Hi, I'm Ms. Wojcowski. I'm the librarian here at Clayton Middle High School. I actually do have a poster of Queen Elizabeth I, the 8th, and ruled England for almost 40 years by herself during a time when that was not a typical role for women. Was able to successfully rule England for from 1558 to 1603, so I think that's 45 years.
My name is Deborah Galston, and I teach 9th grade English. I have always admired Princess Diana. I've always looked up to her. She's about 10 years older than me. So I kind of, when I was younger, looked up to her. Absolutely adored Queen Elizabeth. I loved her. So I just think they're very strong women. Very, very different women, but very, very strong in their own right.
I'm Susan Redfield, and I'm a learning consultant on the child study team. I think the whole generation of the women during World War II, how they stepped up to support our country, stepped into roles mainly held by men, and just kept our country going. So that whole generation of women have really inspired me.
My name is Mrs. Martinez, and I teach Spanish in high school. The woman in history that I look for is Julia de Burgos. She's a Puerto Rican writer, the most important writer in Latin America. I look at her because of the way that she was so passionate about her roots, where she come from, and that really helped me to know how important it is to be proud of where we come from.
But I think for me personally, having two daughters, has really impacted me in an extreme way, that I want them to feel like they have, you know, the ability to do anything, and it shouldn't matter whether they are female. They should never feel like they are less than anyone else, and I'm trying to empower them every day to make sure that they know that.
But my children, my daughters, I have three daughters, and they have changed me completely. I'm not kidding, they really have. They're a lot smarter than me, they're a lot kinder than me, and they're just emotionally intelligent. So I love that. I love that about them.
I would have to say the most influential person is my best friend. And we met in the 9th grade, and I just really look up to her because she goes after her goals. She doesn't give up. She supports other women, and she is always finding ways to uplift people.
My advice to young women would be to never recognize a ceiling. Always reach beyond, okay? Don't put yourself in a box. Don't ever feel like you can't be who you are. I tell my own children this all the time. You need to be authentic. You need to be your authentic self all throughout your life. And reach beyond that ceiling.
Inspiring them to believe in themselves. Every lesson that I do, I try to put a little different things to let them know that they can do it.
In general, in particular, because I'm the librarian, I try to make sure that I represent diversity in my collection in all forms, because it's important for everyone to see different people in roles that are strong and prominent.
So within my community, I coach youth lacrosse, and I have a group of 8 and 9 year old girls who are, you know, they have grit and they play with strength, and I try to make them just feel like they can do anything, that anything is possible. Obviously, in my daily life here at Clayton, I try to also inspire and empower girls to feel special and important.
And I saw her face. I'm a believer and not a trace.
Good morning, Clay. Welcome back to News on Deck. Today's Wednesday, March 30th. I'm Angel.
And I'm Leah. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Please be seated.
Attention staff and students, if you missed Honk Drama Club's amazing musical this weekend, don't worry, you can still see it. See Miss Zambone to order yours today. Mr. Zambone's video students recorded the play in its entirety from multiple angles. Now to Leah with more announcements.
Attention all students, the lip sync battle is back. The yearbook club will be hosting the battle on Wednesday, May 11th at 6 p.m. We are in need of performers. Students and staff both can perform. Please see Ms. Johnson or Ms. Cotilla to sign up. And don't forget, you can also see Ms. Cotilla or Ms. Johnson with any questions about ordering yearbooks. Congratulations to Chris Sowers for being picked Man of the Year by the AFGM organization. Chris had been nominated by head football coach Harvey to represent Clayton High School. He was nominated for being a good person both on and off the field. Out of the 11 players nominated, Chris was the recipient of the 2021 Man of the Year Award. Great work, Chris. Back to Angel for lunch.
For lunch today, the cafeteria will be serving chicken fajitas with the vegetable of the day on the side, along with a variety of fruits and veggies to choose from, as long as juice or milk to drink. Remember to clean up after yourself and throw away your trash. For Clayton sports today, there will be a boys varsity scrimmage against West Hampton Tech at 4 o'clock, playing home in the baseball fields. Good luck, Clippers. Before we go, teachers, remember to send down any dress code violations to the main office at this time. Thank you.
That's all for News on Deck.
We'll see you tomorrow.